marriage in Dilli Sud village.
Good morning, Meenu. What are you doing?
Good morning, Buzz. I am watching that parrot. Look, it is looking for something. Come, let's go and find out. Raja, stop barking. Parrot will get scared.
That means lots of trees. Meenu, if we plant thousands of trees, can we have a forest near our place also?
Buzz, forest does not mean just planting trees. There are lots of plants, birds and animals in a forest. They are dependent on each other to live.
They are dependent on each other to live. But how?
Have you seen a deer or a rabbit? They eat grass and other green leaves. So they need the plants to live. They are dependent on them.
Oh, like that. Now I know. Then animals like a lion or a tiger eat deer and rabbit. So they are dependent on them to live.
You are right, Buzz. So, forest is not just about planting lots of trees. There is lots of life in the forest and they are dependent on each other to live.
You are right, Meenu. But in Jharkhand, the people are also very closely linked to the forest.
People are closely linked to the forest. How?
I will tell you how. I will start with what all I did in Jharkhand. Then you will understand. I went to a village called Dilli Sud. It is near a bigger village called Mudu.
Are these villages in Ranchi?
They are near Ranchi. The people of Delhi Zoo looked very happy. They were getting ready for a marriage.
Oh, there was a marriage in the village. Even I like marriages. Everyone is happy and there is lots of good food to eat.
Oh yes, I met a sweet little girl just like Minu. Her name was Sulami. She was going with her friends to the forest.
To the forest? With her friends? Were they not afraid?
Buzz, I told you, in Jharkhand, the lives of these people are linked to the forests. They are Adivasis.
Adivasis? Who are they?
I know about Adivasis. They are forest people and there are tribes. They are very attached to the forests.
That's right. They cannot live without forests.
I know. People's lives are linked to the natural surroundings around them. Like people living near rivers get very attached to the river and their everyday life gets linked to the river. Same with people living in mountains also.
You are right, Minu. The people of Delhi Sood village love their forests and the children enjoy going there.
You said Sulami and her friends were going to the forest. Did you also go with them? What were they going for?
Yes, I also went with them. I sat on Sulami's shoulders. She was very happy to take me. They were going to collect dry leaves of the salt tree.
Salt trees? What is that?
It is a type of tree that grows in the forests of Jharkhand. It is very big and children collect the leaves that fall from the tree.
Then, do all forests have only salt trees?
No, Buzz. All forests do not have the same kind of trees. Different forests have different types of trees. They could be sal, pine, eucalyptus, or any other kind of trees.
Oh, so this forest has sal trees. But why did they collect the leaves of sal trees?
I will tell you why. Just be patient, Buzz. On the way to the forest, Sulami and her friends started singing in their language. It was so sweet. I saw many types of birds. I have never seen so many before.
Parrot, you must have been very happy to see different types of birds. Were there other parrots also?
Yes, there were. All the birds were chirping happily. The children started imitating their sounds. Everyone was very happy. Then Sulami and her friends started collecting leaves and bamboo sticks.
Oh, they have bamboo also in their forests?
Oh yes, they do. By afternoon, they had collected lots of leaves and bamboo sticks. Soon they all returned to the village.
What did they do with the leaves and bamboo sticks, Parrot?
Not so people from the village sat together and started stitching the lace and made pleats out of them.
Pleats with leaves? How did they stitch the lace together? With a thread?
No, Meenu. They used thin bamboo strands to stitch up the lace. They made lots of pleats, tied them and kept them aside. Then they wove lovely baskets with the bamboo sticks.
What did they use these plates for?
What do people use plates for, Buzz? Just to eat.
Meenu is right. It was the day of the marriage. The whole village came for the marriage. After the marriage, they all sat down to eat on a wooden log. Then the plates were kept and food was served on these plates.
Oh, that must have been lots of fun. To eat from a plate made of leaves. Parrot, the people of that village use the leaves from forest to make plates and bamboo to make baskets. That is why they are so attached to the forest.
Yes, Meenu, the Adivasis are very attached to the forest. They need the forests for their living. The Adivasi families collect leaves and herbs from the forests and sell them in the bazaar. They make little money out of that for their living. But things were going to change. So Tsunami's mother was very sad.
Why? What happened?
A contractor was taking over the forest. He told the villagers that they cannot pick even a single leaf anymore.
A contractor? Who is a contractor? Why did he say that they cannot pick any leaves?
Buzz, a contractor of a forest is a person who pays money to the government to take control of things in that forest. He has a right over things in the forest for which he has paid money. The government does not allow cutting of trees by anyone. So, he also cannot cut any trees in the forest. He will only pick up all herbs or leaves and sell them in the bazaar. If anyone else picks up the leaves or collects sticks, he can stop them.
Oh, that's so sad. Then, what will the people of Dillisood village do? They also need the leaves and sticks to make things and earn money.
Buzz, some people in the village are scared of the contractor. But some people in the village have started a protest. They say that the forest is theirs and they have taken very good care of it for thousands of years. They say that they are people of the forest and they have right over the forest.
That's right, Parrot. They don't even cut the trees of the forest.
That is why they are angry. They say that forests are their wealth and they use only as much as they need. They do not use all of it. They say that forest is their collective bank.
Collective bank? What is that?
Buzz, it means that it belongs collectively to everyone, not just to you or me. It is a natural resource and everyone has a right over it.
If everyone has a right over it, then why will the contractor stop them from picking up leaves?
Buzz, even natural resources sometimes cannot be used by everyone. Like digging out minerals from deep inside the ground or drawing out oil. These are given out to contractors or companies so that they take them out and sell it.
Oh, it's like that. Then what will the villagers do? How will they earn their money?
That is why Sulami's parents are sad these days. Many villagers are also sad. They have only small pieces of land and did not have a good rainfall last year. Now they are planning to go to some towns looking for jobs.
That is sad, Parrot. But sometimes even forests are destroyed to make big dams, roads or bridges. I read it in the newspaper. It is bad for people like Sulami and other Adivasis who are so attached to the forest. They lose their forest and their earning then. But dams, roads and bridges are also good for many people.
Oh, what a big problem. It is good for some and bad for some other. Friends, what do you think? Is it good or is it bad?
It is a difficult question. You can discuss with your friends also. Parrot, does Sulami go to school like us?
Yes, Meenu. She goes to school. All her friends go through the forest to reach their school. They like to go through the forest every day.
Now, if they go to a new place, she has to go to a new school.
Meenu, what are you doing? Who are you talking to?
Grandma, please come here. Meet our new friend, Parrot. Grandma, Parrot was telling about the Adivasis of Jharkhand. It is sad that they have to move out of their forests.
Move out of their forests? But why? They don't have to move out now. There is a new law called the Right to Forest Act 2007. I read it in the newspaper. It says that people who have been living for at least 25 years in the forest have a right over the forest land and what is grown on it. They cannot be removed from the forest. Their Gram Sabha should protect their forest then.
Oh, Grandma, I did not know about this law. It's good that you told us. So, anyone living inside a forest for more than 25 years cannot be asked to go?
Yes, that's right. Parrot, is this village inside the forest?
Yes, Grandma. It is inside the forest. It is surrounded by forests on all sides.
Parrot, then you should go and tell people in Sulami's village not to get worried. They have a right over their forest. But their Gram Sabha should protect the forest. The people cannot destroy the forest or misuse its wealth.
Meenu, I will fly just now and tell them. Thank you, Grandma. See, it's always good to know about your rights. Nobody in that village knew about this law.
Parrot, that's because people don't know how to read and write. They cannot read newspapers. That is why I always tell everyone that they should learn to read and write. Only then will they know about their rights. Then no one can cheat them.
But Grandma, only children can go to school. How will older people learn now?
Buzz, who told you older people cannot learn to read and write? There is no age limit for learning. Have you seen the evening class in the village? So many people come there to learn.
Yes, Grandma. Even Sita Auntie, Ramu Uncle, Salim Uncle and Rani Auntie go there. They can read Hindi and write numbers now. They can even add and subtract.
I will tell the people in that village also to learn now. Bye, Minu. Bye, Chinu. Bye, Grandma. Buzz, don't drink too much of honey. Then there will be not much left for other bees and butterflies.
I will not, Parrot. It is a natural resource and I will share it wisely with everyone.
Friends, have you seen a forest? Do you have an Adivasi friend? Have you asked her about forests? Is there any public place in your area which you are not allowed to use? Do you like forests? What will you do to protect forests? Think.
Friends, will you help Parrot to give very short answers? Will you tell your answers loudly? Capital of Jharkhand? Ranchi. Forest people are called Adivasis. A person who pays money to the government to control things in a forest. Contractor of the forest. A natural resource that belongs to everyone collectively. Collective bank or collective wealth. This committee must protect the interests of the tribal. Gram Sabha or the village panchayat. Let's help Bert to fill in the blanks now. Trees grow in the forest of Jharkhand. Tall trees grow in the forest of Jharkhand.
are also known as forest people. Adivasis are also known as forest people. There are trees and in forests. Birds Animals Plants There are trees, birds, animals, and plants in forests. Adivasis make by stitching leaves together. Plates Adivasis make plates by stitching leaves together. Aag does not allow cutting of trees by anyone. Government Our government does not allow cutting of trees by anyone. Forests are sometimes destroyed to build and Dams Roads Bridges Forests are sometimes destroyed to build dams, roads, and bridges. MS Dhoni comes from the state of Jharkhand. MS Dhoni comes from the state of Jharkhand. Will you help Frog to find out which of the following sentences are true and which are false? The life of the Adivasis is linked to forests. True. Animals and plants are dependent on each other. true.
Our government allows people to cut trees.
False.
Adivasis say that they don't need the forests at all.
False.
One can learn to read and write at any age.
True.
Let's now try to answer these questions. Friends, will you also write the answers in your notebook? Can you tell what you can find in a forest? There are lots of plants, trees, birds, and animals in a forest. They are all dependent on each other to live. So a forest does not mean only lots of trees. How are plants and animals dependent on each other to live? Can you give examples? A rabbit or a deer eat grass and other plants to live. The tiger or lion eat the deer and rabbit to live. That is how they are all dependent on each other. Do all forests have the same type of trees? What kind of trees do you find in a forest? No, all forests do not have the same type of trees. Different forests have different types of trees. We can find sal trees in the forests of Jharkhand. But forests in other places have trees like pine, eucalyptus, teak, etc.
Adivasis.
Adivasis are known as forest people. They cannot live without forests. They collect leaves and herbs from the forest and sell them in the market. They also make bamboo baskets and leaf plates. They do not pluck the leaves but use the fallen ones. They are careful not to destroy the forests. Do you know who a contractor of forest is? A contractor of a forest is a person who pays money to the government to take control of things in a forest. He has a right over things in the forest for which he has paid money. He can stop anyone from taking away anything from the forest. What is a collective bank or collective wealth? A collective bank or collective wealth means something that belongs to everybody. It is a natural resource and everyone has a right to it. The Adivasis say that forests are a collective bank
and everyone should be allowed to use them. Is there any law to protect the rights of the Adivasis? Yes, there is a new law called the Right to Forest Act 2007. It says that people who have been living in the forest for at least 25 years have a right over the forest land and what is grown on it, but they cannot destroy or misuse it. Their Gram Sabha has to protect such forests. Sometimes forests are destroyed for the sake of development, to build dams, factories, etc. This affects the trees, animals, and people living in such forests. What do you think will happen to them? Do you think development is also important? You can discuss with your friends. Friends, do you want to see how a leaf plate and a bamboo basket are made? Let's draw it now. Leaf plate. Bamboo basket